Hello, Françoise. Hello, everyone. Françoise, you and your team published 4 super interesting studies about fasting this year. Could you please give our audience an update about what they are?
Hello, and hello, everyone. Yes, with pleasure. But the first study I would talk about is the study on oxidative stress and the increase of the total antioxidant capacity of the blood during a fasting. We were a bit worried because antioxidants, at least the exogenous ones, are coming from fruits, from vegetables, from spices, from a lot of products that we stop giving during fasting, since you just get a juice and a bit of a vegetable soup. So were the people more oxidized during the fasting? And this is why we made a study with the team of Professor Kouretas in Greece, and we could find that the total antioxidant capacity was enhanced during fasting, and not because of the exogenous antioxidants, but because of the endogenous antioxidants. Two of them that will probably surprise you are uric acid and bilirubin, and they are increased in the fasting, sometimes to levels where by eating people you will have problems. And this is probably an evolutionary mechanism, and the whole machinery of antioxidants, the enzymes are stimulated during the fasting. So that was a very good success, especially because we have a diminution of the oxidative stress during fasting. If you do it in a facility like by Buchinger Wilhelmi, you have the possibility of diminishing it. People don't smoke. You have to stop during the fasting. And then you have no ionizing radiation. You have no pollution as well as possible, as water, soil, air pollution. And this is conveying a lot of oxidative stress. And the inflammation diminish, which is also participating to the oxidative stress. These were the 2 studies we had on this topic. And it was really showing that we can let fast without thinking that the oxidative capacity will be reduced. The contrary is the truth. Now, the second study I would talk about is a study on blood pressure published in the Journal of the American Heart Association. We had a big cohort of 1,610 persons fasting from 5 to 20 days. It was mean values, and we saw, when you looked at the blood pressure, that in general blood pressure goes down, but if you are hypertense, non-medicated, your blood pressure goes down the most. If you are hypertense, medicated, normally your blood pressure shouldn't be too high because of the medication. Well, we could eliminate the medication in 25% of the cases and reduce it quite strongly in 50% of the cases, meaning that fasting is a possibility to get rid of drugs, at least during the fasting. And this effect was maintained on food reintroduction. So this could be the start of your new lifestyle, diminishing the tendency to high blood pressure. A very interesting remark is that by normotensive people, normotension is about between 135 and 80, more or less. If you come with 135 over 85 or 90, in some associations it's tolerated, then you go back to 120 to 80. So you don't diminish the blood pressure very much if it was normal at the beginning, but you do it still better. And then we had a group of 39 women having a low blood pressure, and they had the tendency to get up. It was significant. And this is showing us that fasting is a modulating practice, especially for the blood pressure. Then the next study was interested in the fat metabolism. You know that there is a controversy on cholesterol values, and many specialists on lipids and cholesterol go away from the total cholesterol as an interesting value, because you have the good one and the bad one in this total cholesterol. So we look at the triglycerides, which are going down very rapidly during the fasting, and the more, the higher. So a normalization, which is extraordinary. And then we looked at the LDL cholesterol, which is supposed to be the bad cholesterol. And even in this fraction, we have several subfractions. And the small, dense LDL particles are the more atherogenic, meaning that when they are in big quantity in circulation, then you have the more chances to have an obstruction of your vessels, atherosclerosis. And interestingly enough, by fasting, according to our program, long-term with the Buchinger-Wilhelmi method, we had a diminution, the biggest diminution on the small, dense lipoproteins. So a good result showing that if you repeat the fasting regularly, you might have a prevention against atherosclerosis or a limitation of it. And the fourth study I would like to mention is the last one. This is a very big study for us because it's after 40 years of fighting against the people reproaching us not to give proteins. It's a study who shows that during a fast, you have not very big utilization of proteins first. Then at the beginning of the fast, it's a bit more than at the end because you have a diminution of the protein utilization during the fasting. And after the fasting, you have a regeneration of the protein. So a huge protein synthesis and an activation of stem cells. So that now the question could be really, is protein utilization during fasting therapeutic? And it seems at least once, it doesn't come all from the muscles. That was a sort of a dogma, which we never believed because we see people, they enhance their capacity of exercising. They have a better performance of their muscle mass even after 3 weeks of fasting. And this correlates with what we measured in 10 days of fasting by 16 young men. We saw an enhancement of the performance of the leg muscles and normally the other muscle groups we examined were normal. So performance is better or same. And at the same time, you have these other aspects like the microcirculation that is enhanced, the mitohomesis, the mitochondria, the little power plants of the body, who are rejuvenated, so that altogether the performance of the people fasting is enhanced after the fast. We looked if the muscles are protected during the fasting, which other tissues, metabolically active tissues, were concerned. And this was difficult to say, but from other studies, we know that the liver shrink, the heart shrink, the intestinal lining walls shrink, and they are, after the fasting, when you reintroduce the food, regenerated out of stem cells and new synthesis. So this was, in other times, protein was a sort of limiting factor where everybody was warning against fasting because of that. And now we are thinking a certain well-controlled protein utilization during the fasting can have extraordinary regeneration effects if you go back to food in a proper way afterwards. So that would be what we produced and we published in the last 2 years. Some minor articles, you can find them also in our publication list. I hope to see you soon. Thank you very much and have a nice day.